You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Okay, now I have the upper body focused in the viewer, and I'm going to roto this upper body. So here I've saved some time and I've copied over my tracking shapes and my layers. I've turned off the shape for the shoulders, but here's the tracking shape. And I'll show you how I made the shape with the magnetic freehand tool. So I click Shift F, or you can click this icon over here. I'm actually going to center my shoulders in the viewer a little bit more. I'm going to tap down with my pen, but I'm just going to hover over the edge and let the line draw itself. First, I'm going to make sure I'm in my shoulders layer. I am. That's good. I will click down here, and I'm just hovering over this edge. And when I get to this juncture where it won't be able to find the edge anymore, click down and drag. And then when I get to this edge here, just hovering over the tablet with my pen, click down to the edge, and then just drag underneath and complete with the circle. I look at the amount of points. I think I'm okay. If I wanted less, I could change this detail amount to lower. And I'll click R to get into the reshape mode. And then I'm going to select all the points, shift click control point, and then right click, and I'm going to make them all be spline point tensions, because sometimes you can have corners in there. I'll delete some of the points. And go in for a few quick edits. So it found this edge pretty well. Just have to move a few things out here. And to the other side. These juncture points sometimes are a little bit problematic, but not impossible to fix quickly. Okay, now we'll see how this shape worked out. We can even go into the stabilization mode. We'll find the shoulders layer. Has to be here somewhere. Okay, there it is at the bottom. That looks pretty good. So it's just a few little edits here. I think I'll just make one on the last keyframe. Select all the points here and just use my arrow keys to move in. And then maybe a little bit here. So it's pretty quick tracking and a pretty quick way to make a shape as well. And I did the same with the screen left hood and the screen right hood. And I'll just turn on those shapes right now. And we'll go out of the stabilization mode. So I probably was able to do all those three shapes in about 5 minutes. Using the same method, some tracking, and then the freehand tool, the magnetic freehand.